Quad J, where we explore using quadratics to solve real-world problems. This first problem talks about a piece of wire measuring 50 feet attached to a telephone pole. The distance on the bottom from the pole to the wire is 10 feet greater than the height. And I want to find out how far up does the pole, does the wire reach. So I'm first looking at my wire, and I see that it makes a nice right triangle with the ground. So I know that my wire is 50 feet up, and I know that my height is x, and I know that the distance on the ground is the same as the height plus 10. So I can write the distance as x plus 10 when x equals the height. So now that I see I'm using a right triangle, I can just plug this nice into the Pythagorean formula, which is a squared plus b squared equals c squared, where c is my hypotenuse. So I'm plugging them into my formula. I'm going to FOIL out x plus 10 squared to get x plus 20x plus 100 equals 2500. Now I want to get my equation equal to 0, so I'm going to subtract 2500 from each. So now I get 2x plus 20x minus 2,400 equals 0. So now I notice when I want to factor, I want to divide everything by 2, since that is the GCF. I want to divide everything by 2. Now I get x squared plus 10x minus 1,200 equals 0. I want two things that multiply to negative 1,200 but add to 10. And I get those two things to be 40 and negative 30. So those are going to be my factors. So I'm going to plug those in. X minus 30 times x plus 40 equals 0. And then I'm going to solve. I'm going to set each one equal to 0. And get x equals 30 and x equals negative 40. I need to remember I can't have a negative distance, so I want to immediately cross out x equals negative 40 since I can't have that. So my height is 30 feet. And that's going to be my answer. Looking at this next problem, the length of a rectangle is 3 more than twice the width. I want to determine the dimensions that will give me a total area of 27 meters. So I'm looking at my initial rectangle. I know that my width is just equal to W. And then my length is actually equal to 2 times the width plus 3. Now, I want to look at the area. So I'm going to use my area formula, which is A equals L times W, length times width. And I'm just going to substitute in my length and my width. So I get 27 equals W times 3 plus 2. All I'm doing is distributing the W to 3 and to 2W to get 27 equals 3W plus 2W squared. I'm setting each side equal to 0. I'm subtracting 27 from each side and just rearranging it a little bit nicer. Now I need to find two factors that multiply negative 54 but add to 3. And I know those two factors are 9 and 6. Using my factoring box, I get that one of my factors is 2w plus 9, and my other factor is w minus. Setting each of these equal to 0, I get W equals negative 9 halves, and W equals 3. Now I know it can't be a negative number, so I'm immediately going to cross that out. So I get that my width is equal to 3 meters, and that's my final answer. Moving on to section 1J, we're going to be talking about projectile motion and how to use our calculator to find different values. So this problem talks about an object being launched directly upward, and then it's obviously going to fall down. So we want to find out, when does the object strike the ground? And I'm given this formula, S of t equals negative 4.9 t squared plus 19.6 t plus 58.8. The first thing I want to do is go into my calculator and type it into my y equals. So y equals my equation. Then I'm going to look at my graph, so I'm going to graph this. And I see that it strikes the ground twice, but on the left side of the x-axis, it's negative, so I'm not really concerned about those values. So the intercept that I'm concerned with is the one on the right side. So I'm just going to go into second trace, calculate my zero, give my left bound, and again, I'm looking at the x-intercept on the left side, or the right side of the x-axis. Left bound and right bound, guess, and it gives me that my zero is at x equals 6. So I know that the object strikes the ground at 6 seconds. And so that's my final answer. My second equation is about a ball being thrown up, and then obviously the ball comes back down. And the function I'm given is negative 16 t squared plus 48 t plus 288. And it's asking me, when will the ball reach a height of 320 feet? So again, I want to plug this into my calculator, into the y equals. I'm going to plug in my equation, and then I'm going to graph it just to see how it looks. I can solve this problem one of two ways. I can go to second graph, which will give me a table of values. And I can see, oh, at x equals 1, my height is 320, and also at x equals 2, my height is 320. So my solution to the question is 1. If I needed to change my table set by changing the amount that's going up, I would go to second window, that would bring me to table set, and I would start at 0 and go up by, I could go up by 25.5. Go back to my table and look for my value if I couldn't find it right away. In this particular instance, I can also solve it using factoring. So I noticed that I want to find where my height is 320. So all I have to do is look at my original equation and plug in 320 for my height. Subtracting 320 from both sides, I set my equation equal to 0. I also noticed that every term, I can take out a negative 16. So I'm going to divide both sides by negative 16. Dividing each and every term by negative 16, I'm left with t squared minus 3t plus 2 equals 0. So I want to find factors that multiply by 2 to add to negative 3, and I get negative 2 and negative 1. So now I can factor to t minus 1, t minus 2 equals 0, and I get that t equals 1 and 2 seconds. And that is also what I found on the calculator. Now, this was a really nice problem because it was easily factorable. If it's not, go ahead and just plug it in the calculator and look for the values there. My last second problem is quadratic regression. In this, I'm going to want to use my calculator, especially for it. So at 821 feet, the CN Tower is one of the world's tallest self-supporting structure. So I'm standing at the top of the tower, and I drop a penny from there, and it falls to the ground. The table shows me the time and the distance at which the penny is falling. So I want to write an equation that is going to model the data within this table. So the data within the table, that's what I'm trying to model. And then I'm going to try to find where was the penny located after falling 10.5 seconds. I'm going to go to my calculator, and I'm going to go to my stat button, which is right under the list. So I'm going to go to edit. I'm going to plug in two lists, one with my x values and the next X with my Y values. Make sure to plug in your X values with list 1 and your Y values with list 2. Next, I'm going to go back to stat after I have my values plugged in, and I'm going to go to the calc. And this is where I'm going to go down to number 5, which is quadratic regression, because I know that I need to make a quadratic formula out of this. So I'm going to go down to number 5, press enter, and here we go. My X list is list number 1, so it's set in super nice. Y list is list number 2, and that's the only thing I have to worry about. I'm just going to press calculate next. Then it gives me this format. It says y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, where a is negative 16, b is 0, and c is 1821. So now I'm just going to write it down. A equals negative 16, b equals 0, and c equals 1821. And I'm just going to write it as an equation now. Using the ax squared plus bx plus c form, I get negative y equals negative 16x squared plus 1821. So now I'm concerned with where my time at 10.5, where is this penny? How tall is it? So all I'm going to do is take my equation from my calculator and plug in 10.5 for x. So I get negative 16 times 10.5 squared plus 1821. So plugging this in, I get negative 16 times 10.5 squared is 1764 plus 821. Equals 57 feet. And that is my final answer for this problem. Please come to class with any questions, and I hope you enjoy.